Why is it so important for kids to wear a mask?
So it's important for all of us to wear a mask, and children need to be protected just like adults need to be protected. The recommendations are for children to wear a mask if they're at least over the age of 2 and don't have any special medical conditions that would preclude them being able to wear one.
Are there any special guidelines for students with special needs?
There are, but that should really be done by the child's provider, medical provider, and their family. So having that conversation with your pediatrician is important before making the decision about the mask wearing for children with special medical needs.
Now, there are all different kinds of masks. Are there any particular recommendations with the type of masks that kids should be wearing, the gaiters versus around the ear loops?
So probably for children around the ear loops is a little bit better because the gaiters can actually fall down quite often. And so we would suggest using a cloth or a surgical style mask with the ear loops that connect at the back.
So as parents get their kids ready for another school year, how can they help their children prepare and get used to wearing a mask?
Sure, I think a lot of people are having some difficulty surrounding mask wearing. And for children, we need to make it a safe and a pleasant activity. So at the beginning, we should probably make it a fun activity. So picking out masks that are decorative, that have bright colors or polka dots on them, something that they can see as being fun. And then practice wearing it along with their parents practice wearing it. Do that for short periods of time and work up to about a 30-minute interval of wearing the mask so that they can have that feeling of it on their face and know that it's a safe thing and that they can breathe appropriately. And then have a plan for rewards. So do some fun activities and then reward them for appropriately wearing their mask. You can do things like take a loved doll or a teddy bear and start having the teddy bear wear the mask, and that's a great way to start that conversation with your child about mask wearing.
Great. We know kids like to trade things like action figures, and if we make these masks too cool and fun, are there any concerns about them trading the mask like they trade other things, and what might we address that?
That can be a problem, as children really do like to do the trading game. So I think it's about having conversations with your children. So the mask should be fun, and it can be decorated along as it's not a surgical mask like I'm wearing. The surgical masks lose their integrity if you decorate them. So cloth masks can be decorated, but not these. And then talk with your child about it being a personal hygiene issue. So just as we tell them not to share toothbrushes or brushes or hats, we would say don't share your mask. That's your own personal mask.
And what about lunchtime when kids might take their mask off? Is there a proper way to store a mask?
There is. And lunchtime, it depends on what kind of setting the child is going to be in for lunch. Some schools I know are having no cafeteria style eating and eating only at your desk. For those instances, you could have the child remove the mask safely, place it in the corner with the outside up so that the side that goes towards the public does not touch the desk. If they are in a communal setting, then one of the other ways that you can safely store a mask is in a paper bag, like a lunch bag.
Great. And what about after school, maybe when they get off the bus and they're walking home, should they keep their masks on for that time?
So it depends on what the situation is. Some children, even after getting off the bus, walk together down a street or in a neighborhood. If that's the case, then they should continue to wear the mask until they get into their personal vehicle or their home.
Great. And once they arrive home, do you have any tips to store masks at home? And also, maybe how often should they be washed?
So the storage of masks at home, I find in my own home, we've designated an area right inside the front door that has a table that we used to throw our keys on all the time. And we have now separate places for our masks to be there. It's a great place because you take it off immediately upon coming in, and then it's a reminder as you leave the door to put your mask back on. As far as cleaning the mask, a surgical mask like I'm wearing is disposable and can't be washed and shouldn't be cleaned, should be discarded after use. But for the cloth masks, they should be washed daily for children after their use.
So it might be wise to think about getting multiple masks then.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Any questions that you've been getting or that our providers have been getting in our pediatric practices from parents that you want to address?
Yes, I would like to address some concerns that we've heard from some families. I think that they are worried that wearing a mask will cause decreases in oxygen levels in their child and increases in carbon dioxide levels in their child, but that does not happen. These masks are extremely breathable and it does not cause either a decrease in oxygen or an increase in CO2. They're very safe to use.
Anything that we've missed that you want to touch on?
So I would like to say that as we move back towards school and at some point in-person schooling, it is important that you visit your pediatrician to have that exam done for children and to get all of the immunizations that are required for school, especially during this year. We want everyone to be as safe as they possibly can be from all diseases.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.